this video, I'll be showing you guys how I highlight and contour my face to create a more sculpted look. The areas I'll be bringing forward and highlighting are my forehead, my nose bridge to make it look like I've got a taller nose, under my eyes to brighten that area up, my Cupid's bow to create fuller looking lips, under my cheeks, and lastly my chin. Now by highlighting these areas, I'm going to make it stand out and appear more prominent. So make sure you highlight the areas on your face that you want to stand out. The areas I'll be contouring and pushing back are around my forehead near my hairline, the sides of my nose, under my cheekbones, and lastly my jawline to create a slimmer looking face. Alrighty, so let's get started. For highlighting, I'm using a concealer that's two shades lighter than my skin tone, NC20 by MAC. I personally like contouring and highlighting with cream products. I find that it's much easier to blend, but you can also do it with powder if you wish. Now here I've just got CC cream on, so I'm going to highlight on top of that. I'm going to start off with my forehead, so I'm just going to brighten up that area. And then move on to my nose bridge to create a slimmer and taller looking nose. Now ladies, the thinner you draw this line, the slimmer your nose will look. So make sure you keep that in mind when highlighting this area. Next, I'm going to start highlighting under my eyes to brighten up that area. If you've ever looked at Kim Kardashian's makeup, which I'm sure we all have, you'll notice that her face is very three-dimensional and really lifted. Now, a trick is, if you want that look, is to actually bring out the highlighted area towards just under your temples. This will help pull back and lift that cheekbone and give you that Kim Kardashian look. Now, I'm going to move on to my lips. If you want fuller, sexier looking lips, try highlighting your philtrum column and also your Cupid's bow. Unfortunately, we're not all blessed with Angelina Jolie looking lips, so just fake it till you make it. Then I'm going to move on to my chin. And lastly, I'm going to highlight under my cheeks, just on top of where my jawline would be, and that's going to help bring that area forward. Let's move on to contouring. Today I'll be using Tom Ford's Shade and Illuminate in Intensity 1. I love, 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 love this product. It's my new favourite contouring product. I really like the darker shade. It's got a grey undertone which makes it perfect for contouring. Now when choosing a product, don't use anything that's shimmery or too bronzy because you're going to end up looking like an Oompa Loompa and that is not sexy. Now I'm going to start off by contouring just under my cheekbone, which will give me a more sculpted effect. If you don't know where to stop, just make sure you don't go any further than your pupil. So I'm just going to do the same with the other side and then move on to my forehead. Now I'm going to move on to the sides of my nose. This will help create a shadow and make my nose appear skinnier and taller as well. And lastly, I'm just going to shade in my jawline to create a slimmer looking face. Now that I'm done with that, I look somewhat like a tribal warrior. But don't worry, the next step is to blend it all in. Here I'm buffing and blending the colours in using circular motions. As you can see, once I blend it in, it starts to look really natural. So I don't look as scary and you can't tell where I've actually highlighted or contoured. It just looks really nice and it looks like my skin. Now that I finished blending, I need to use powders to set the cream products. For the areas that I contoured, I've been using Hoola by Benefit to set these areas and further sculpt my face. If you're looking for a contouring powder, I'd highly recommend this one. It's not too warm and it matches a lot of skin tones. I love using it on my clients. I like to use an angled blush brush to apply the contouring powder. I find that it's a perfect shape and size for my face, and also if I squeeze the bristles together, it perfectly fits the sides of my nose. Then for the lighter areas, I'm just going to set it with a translucent powder. After all that powdering, my skin is looking a bit matte, so I'm going to bring back some sheen using the Illuminate shade in the Tom Ford Compact. I'm going to apply this highlighter to the high points on my face. Now, to avoid oily looking skin, don't overdo it, and instead of applying it to your forehead, try applying it on top of your brow bone. This will give your skin a nice dewy glow without looking like a grease ball. See? It's nice and dewy. Finally, to finish off the look, I'm going to apply some blush to give myself a bit of colour, and here I'm using MAC Warm Soul. And ta-da! That's all there is to contouring. It's really simple and easy. You just got to make sure you select the right shades to highlight and contour with. Here are some before and after images to show you guys the difference. In the first image, my face is quite flat. In the second image, I look quite scary, but in the third image, my face looks more sculpted and more defined. Now, can you guys spot the difference? Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. Let me know in the comment box below how you guys usually contour, or if you have any tips and tricks. Also, let me know what other videos you'd like me to make. And yeah, I'll speak to you guys next time. Bye!